Famer Tracy McGrady, Hall of Famer Scottie Pippen. I think he's going to make it into the Hall of Fame. What do you guys think?
You never know.
Dwyane Wade.
You never know.
Yeah, you got to cross all those fingers and toes, please. It has been lovely chatting with you, having you up here talk about your hometown, your documentary. I want to know, though, living in L.A. now, as you do, you get the up-close front row seat to your good friend LeBron James, and he is in his 17th season leading this Lakers team at the top of the West.
Yeah.
You've known him for almost 20 years, but what are you learning about him now?
I mean, first of all, we all know it's just incredible, you know, what he's been able to do from a standpoint of his health. You know, he's really, when I watched him in Miami to now, you know, just watching the way that he focuses on his body and his mind, you know, to continue to go out every year and be arguably the greatest player in the game. You know how mentally tough that is. That's what I'm impressed of. I'm impressed about his mental approach to the game of basketball, more so than the physical and the stats and all that. That is great. But just the way he loves the game, he looks like a kid every night that he plays the game of basketball. And, you know, for someone who's been covered since he was 16 years old, that has to do so much, you know, from a standpoint of commercials and movies and this and that, he still has that love and that attention to detail to the game of basketball. And it's just great to watch.
So he's still playing.
I got a question for you. You're in L.A. now.
You watch No.
Come on.
Okay,
let's go here. Watching your best friend play night in and night out. Do you see some struggles out there where you can kind of fit in and help the Lakers?
Absolutely not. I don't even look at the game like that no more.
Really?
I don't look at the game like
Empty
that no
chain.
More.
You were that
I am a
Empty
fan
chain,
of basketball, bro. And I just watch it as a fan. I don't want to play no more. No one wants to see that.
Scottie Pippen wants to see that.
Scottie probably can come back right now.
No.
I mean, look. Listen.
I think this needs to be said, though. And, you know, unfortunately, what transpired with Kobe, I never really got a chance because – you know, I came in with him, and I really never got a chance to tell him how much I appreciate him. So I want to tell Dwyane, competing against him in the Eastern Conference when I was in Orlando and when I moved to Houston, I mean, he was a guy that I competed against. How much of, you know, he really meant to the game, his approach to the game, his tenacity, ferocious competitor. So I just want to tell him how much I appreciate you, your greatness. I mean, it was amazing to watch you play from afar and to compete against this guy. I mean, it was amazing. So.
And I want to piggyback off of that and say that since my career was over, you and Kobe Bryant were my favorite two players to watch.
Look at that.
You guys have inspired me to watch basketball night in and night out, the way you played, the way you approached the game. It gave me so much energy to watch.
Yeah.
I feel like number two and number three, two guard that I've ever seen. I would put Michael first. I had this guy ahead of Kobe for most of his career, but Kobe surpassed him. But this dude was a hell of a player.
Yeah, you gotta
come on our set more often to get all this.
Gotta appreciate greatness.
I want to revisit a couple of moments from this great career we keep talking about. So it is time to play What Were You Thinking with Dwyane Wade. What were you thinking, Dwyane Wade, when you broke O.J. Mayo's ankles back in 2008? This is one of our favorite highlights.
I was thinking, wow. Make the shot. Make the shot.
Right?
I mean, it don't matter if you don't make it.
Right?
The ankle really looked like it got broke.
All right, next up. What were you thinking, Dwyane Wade, when you dunked on Anderson Varejao back in 2009? If we can show that highlight. Here we go.
You know what? Andy.
Listen.
I apologize. Listen, this was, I had just signed with the Jordan brand. MJ was at the game to watch me play, and I had to do something for him.
Do something.
I felt the moment. You know, it was like in slow motion.
You had that man in an ab workout position. You know, that was nasty.
All right, and last up.
Wow.
What were you thinking, Dwyane Wade? We recreated the banana
boat here, but I
want to know, what was your first impression when you saw the banana boat photo?
I did not want to get on the banana boat. I was peer pressured into getting on that boat. And now we can't get rid of
him. You can't claim that. You can't blame
others. I was peer pressure. I'm telling
you. Your own situation.
You know I'd love to be there. It's just super far.
That's not that far.
We have unlimited data. We can chat all we want. I'm comfy.
But it's like 10 feet.
like I said, super far.
DiGiorno Rising Crust Pizza now has even more cheese. It's so cheesy, you'll need a pickup line to go with it. Like, did it hurt? When all that cheese fell from heaven and landed on you? It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno, now with more cheese.
This is protection in a world of distraction. This is value you can't ignore. Get 0% financing for 60 months and save $1,000 on the 2020 Rogue.
Unlock the Cineverse with Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Of the season when love runs high.
The NBA is headed to Chicago for NBA All-Star 2020.
This is the biggest weekend for the NBA. NBA TV's coverage of All-Star continues.
NBA TV will have All-Star editions of all your favorite shows. Access all things All-Star with the NBA app and NBA.com.
We've got the best athletes on the planet.
Don't miss a moment this All-Star weekend. It's all going down in Chicago.
We're destined for greatness.
The whole thing revolves around Anthony Collins.
That dude is one in a million.
This conference is going to be absolutely insane.
A Sonic blockbuster season continues. Number 9, Maryland, Michigan.
There's a lot of fear in coming back to school. I'm a 40-year-old man that walked in there to get his high school diploma. It was very hard for me, but one of the teachers was Miss Araceli. She gave me direction. Every single time I had a question, she'll put down whatever she's doing and she'll sit there with you until you get it. 50% of getting your high school diploma is walking through those doors. The other 50% is doing the work.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
This is an aligner. Well, to be clear, it's a clear aligner from Smile Directbook. Our aligners take teeth like these and transform them into those. They discreetly take this and turn it into that. We send your aligners directly to you, and in an average of 6 months, you can have a lifetime supply of confidence. Join more than half. At SmileDirectClub.com.
Shows that. Out to Trey, long ball.
The best player in the world. First take.
Yeah. Look at me, 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 look at me now.
Well, the crowd lets you know what they think of it. They gave him a 50. They gave Jordan a 50.
He's the youngest starter in NBA All-Star Game history.
Kobe Bryant.
Get a chance to be around these young players here, share some of the knowledge that I've learned throughout my career so that they can carry on the tradition of the NBA.
Look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me.